Wouldn't it be awful if your memories were making you more anxious than you really needed to be? Join me today on the show and I'll help you mind your memories. Last week on the show, I was helping you stop falling for fear, and this week we're going to focus on the memories that make you fearful in the first place. It might come as a surprise to you, but even the word remember means putting back together. Your memories get reconstructed every time you take them out of your brain and start pondering them. Now, as I enjoy saying, there's always at least two sides to everything in a three-dimensional universe, which means there is a good and a bad about the fact that you reconstruct your memories and that they're open to change. The bad is that if you were mildly anxious about something and you build molehills into mountains in your mind and you change the memories to be far worse than they really were, then that's awful, that's terrible, that really is bad, because it makes you more frightened and more fearful than you really need to be. But on the other side, the good of it is that if you were mildly anxious about something or even frightened, you can overcome that fear and change the way you think about something. Maybe the terrible thing that happened to you once upon a time was a rite of passage that you can feel good about today. You know, I've often told patients in the past that there will come a point when you'll be glad that that problem that we've been working through happened to you. That can sound crazy to a bunch of people, especially if they've got a really serious problem that they'd never wish on their worst enemy. But the thing about challenges is, you get to rise to meet them. If you never got the opportunity to solve a problem or rise to a challenge, your life would be pretty boring and mundane. If memory was perfect, you'd only need one person in any court hearing. I mean, assuming they're not lying. But people's perspectives can be different, even if they all witness the same crime. And if someone mentions that the perpetrator had a mustache, next thing you know, everyone that was there as a witness starts remembering the mustache. However, they might remember it in different colours. He had a ginger mustache. No, it was jet black, with a little bit of salt and pepper. It's really tough to get agreement from everyone about anything on this planet, because everything we experience is filtered through our own perceptual filters. And when you change the memory, it starts going through other filters. Now, the single best way of preserving a memory intact is don't take it out and play with it. Leave it where it is. Don't open the book. Don't stare at the details, because every time you take your memory out to play with or observe, you put it back in a potentially different state, and that's the state that it gets stuck in. So if you saw a red car this morning, but as you were talking to people, they pointed out that that was actually a orange car or a yellow car or even a blue car, you'll update your memory and begin talking about the blue car from that point on. Now, I don't know if it really was red or blue, but in your memory, it's going to have changed colour from that point onwards and forever, unless you see contrary evidence that makes you realise, oh my God, I changed my memory. It wasn't really blue, it was red. I'm fairly sure you've done that by accident more than once. But in a moment, I'm going to invite you into a meditative experience, a journey if you wish. Now, because I know you're a human being, I'm almost certain that you've done that at least once without thinking about it. Maybe twice or three times, not on purpose, or possibly a whole bunch, and you never even had an inkling that you were changing your memories when you were doing it. But that's okay. You know better now, so the future can be different. And in a moment, I'm going to invite you into a meditation where we're going to focus on transforming memories and making them more powerful or nicer to remember. And if you really like meditations, I encourage you to go to worryfreewednesday.show, sign up for notifications about the show, and you'll get three free meditations in your inbox and the occasional gift now and again. But if it's safe and appropriate for you to enter into a meditation in just a few moments with me, then I'm going to invite you in. But not if it's not safe for you to close your eyes and imagine the world's come to a grinding halt while you work on your internal world and the wonderful transformations that you'd like to make there. So either bookmark this to do later or take a seat and begin to get really comfortable with your feet flat on the ground so that you can rest in the chair and feel its full support. Take a deep breath and allow your eyes to close as you focus on the journey that your breathing takes. And allow yourself to enjoy the journey of going deeper within you as you take these words with you and make these words your own. Imagine resting completely and letting go fully now, as with each and every soft exhale, you slowly, slowly, slowly let go of thinking and any concerns about anything that really doesn't need to be in your mind or entertained at all right now. And as you entertain the idea of becoming more and more settled and comfortable and relaxed with those eyes closed, it's easier for you to imagine descending down 10 steps or levels, going deeper into relaxation and calmness with each and every step. Beginning that journey now at the 10th level and going all the way down to 9, 8, 7, 6 and 5, resting, relaxing, letting go and being loose and limp like a rag doll. 6, 5, 4, letting yourself go all the way deep inside and drifting. 3, 2, towards a 1, the full sense of self. And it's nice to feel settled, is it not? Pleasant to simply relax, and nice to allow yourself to remember pleasant things. And as you continue to relax with each and every soft and slow exhale, there may come to mind challenging experiences that you can recall having passed successfully through. Even a difficult birth is over with eventually. And there's always something that can be learned from the procedure or the experience that makes it more pleasant to recall or to linger on memories about. Maybe you grew from your challenge, and when you think about that now, you remember it as the challenge that grew you and made you stronger. You might recall it as that difficult, arduous thing that changed everything about your future. Or maybe it was a difficult time that opened the door to never having to go through that again. And you can feel good about the learnings that you took from that experience. Maybe it, and now, maybe it makes it easy for you to imagine a much better future because you've learned something valuable and you've grown in a considerably useful way. And when you consider how to put to use the education that life's given you, it puts you in far greater control of the rest of your life. Consider that for a moment, as you imagine yourself in the theatre of your mind as powerful, courageous, and resourceful. And when you find a way to feel more resourceful now, you'll be putting those memories away in a few moments in a much better condition. And as you just continue to relax and allow yourself to ponder the wonderful ways in which you've grown through difficult times, you may be amazed at how quickly time passes. For in a moment, I'll invite you back from your drifting and developing your self-imagery and great feelings about you within. I'll invite you to take a easy breath or two or three and begin to move your fingers and toes and start to animate your brain and build strong neurology in your mind by being absolutely determined to continue developing you into the person you deserve to be. As you breathe again and open your eyes, move those hands and fingers, come all the way back to waking consensual awareness, and just take a quick moment to pull yourself together before you go about your day. Join me next week when I'll help you keep present under pressure. But until then, like, love and share the show. I love to read your comments. It's not too late to grab those 3 free meditations at worryfreewednesday.show, and I'll see you next week. Stay confident.
Worry Free Wednesday.